Now moving forward, ladies and gentlemen, it's a time for an TV fireside chat session. And for this very interesting rapid fire round, I would like to invite on stage Ms. Nazia, Associate Editor, ExchangeForMedia.com, along with Mr. Sujit Sudhakaran, Senior Director, Brand Marketing, Myntra, and Ms. Tanuja Pradhan, Head Special Projects and Consumer Insights, Reliance Jio, to please come and join us on stage. Hi.
Hi.
It's rapid fire. I have 5 questions. We have 10 minutes, and
feels
you
like
both
on
have.
A KBC now.
No, it's not. It's coffee with Karan.
Okay.
It's not KBC.
Scary.
And whosoever wins makes no difference because there's no hamper. Oh. So take your time and respond. So the first question is. This is all about content, right? So the first question is the 3 most important pillars of impactful storytelling. We start with Tanuja.
Okay, so for me, it is, brand purpose, which has to be there. It is about the social impact, what your brand is doing for, let's say for everybody in the country. And of course, empathy, it's for me. So these 3.
Sujit.
3 things, insightful, entertaining, and relevant for the times.
2 key trends that are impacting the GEC space, Sujit.
I think GEC is getting more younger today. If you look at a decade back, the content was more older. In terms of age, it's getting younger. And it's getting a much, deserved source of modernity also. So these are 2 things which you see on GEC today.
Okay, for me, maybe, for GEC, youth is not watching TV. So that's that's a trend where, now digitalization is there, so everybody is talking about digital content. Then it is, attention span has limited a lot and it's impatient. Plus, there's a regional content which is emerging. So these 3 things as per us.
Are the trends that you notice in GEC?
Yeah, yeah.
So the next question is Tanuja's. Key aspects that can differentiate your story from your competition?
So, if I talk about Jio, I don't know who's the competition, honestly, because,
know.
there are startups also which are emerging. So we really don't know, how do we prepare with the current competition. I think the core is to stay consistent and, work on the, the brand values which you are famous for or which your consumer need. So that is a very generic answer, but that's true.
So I think what would differentiate every brand's story from the other is how honest the brand is to itself, right? So if you are making an honest story about yourself, people will definitely relate to it. And the honesty comes because you will tell a story which you can live. You will not make up a story, right? When a brand makes up a story, it never works well. A brand need to live a story that it really can, put it out to the consumer at the end of the day. So honesty, I think, is what would make a brand live.
A brand story which is your favorite and which is not your own brand?
I will not talk about old stories. One of the recent things which Lacoste as a brand did was really amazing. When they changed the logo from the croc to a bunch of animals which are actually getting extinct and making only that many t-shirts to say that only so many of that particular animal is there, that's a story from a brand. It's a brand which says that I believe, and the brand believes in sustainability, and the brand was ready to actually change its logo. That's how big can it be otherwise?
Yours,
Tanuja? Yeah, so for me, it's a Volkswagen. One, a story where, instead of extending into cars, they actually opened hotels on the highway to ensure there's a safety for drivers. They can just take a rest and move on. So that actually tells you it is not about staying in your own category. It is about extending beyond and being impactful.
A constraint that comes in the way of content.
I don't know whether it's a constraint. There is so much of content out there. So quality and figuring out what is the right level of, dose of brand and not having brand. Because content cannot always have an overload of the brand. There has to be a certain balance to it. That probably is one good challenge.
Tanuja?
I think, now, as we said, that it's a digitization world. It's mobile formats. So creating those formats are expensive. So it is mainly the trade-off between, you know, the creation of content and the data or the monetization of it. So that trade-off maybe.
I think I've asked 5 questions, but I still have 1 more question. I'll start with Tanuja. A long-term content strategy or a campaign-by-campaign approach?
So long-term strategy always, but it can, you know, weave into, you know, some basic agendas, even, you know, which is like, let's say, be innovative, be ahead of the curve, but long-term strategy always.
We agree. I think it's long-term, yes, but you'll have to figure out what is its relevance at this current point in time so that it can help at that point in time for the brand also, but definitely long-term, no questions.
Thank you very much. You can, I think, collect your hampers from events team if they have any.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.